All right, so we got that done. All right, this story, this kind of bothers me. This kind of bothers me a lot. And it begs the question as to how video games are rated. And now, I don't think that games that are put onto iOS and Android, I don't think that those games that are put onto cell phones, I don't think that they are run by the ESRB. I could be wrong about that, but I just don't remember ever seeing a T for teen or that kind of thing on a game on the iOS or Android. And the reason why I'm talking about this is because Nintendo has made a change to Animal Crossing. And in my opinion, I feel like this should change the age rating. Now, I know that Apple has its own age rating, but I don't really understand what that means. The age rating, like, my son could play a game where he could talk to other people on the internet and they could say that that's 4+. And I don't like that. I don't think that that's good. I don't think that that's appropriate. So every time that my son asks to download something to an iOS device, I have to go and look and see, can people talk to you in this app? And I want to try and protect him from the horrible people that are on the internet. So that bothers me that Apple's doesn't do that kind of thing. And I think that that's something that needs to be included in Apple's way of ranking games, but like what age that they should be appropriate for. And I think that probably anything that has internet communication should be ranked for 13+. Now, ESRB, beside the point, because I don't think ESRB is on these phones at all, the reason I'm talking about this is because Animal Crossing Pocket Camp has now added randomized loot boxes. And as far as I'm concerned, this is gambling. And I feel like if Animal Crossing Pocket Camp had an ESRB rating at the beginning, it would probably be E for everyone. And now that it has randomized loot boxes, kind of like a gacha style system, very much similar to Fire Emblem Heroes, I feel like that would change its ESRB rating. And I feel like the game is no longer appropriate for children to play unsupervised. Whereas before that, I would have no problem with my son playing Animal Crossing Pocket Camp, or pretty much any kid, unsupervised. Now, you got to know your kids. And I honestly, at this point, even though they added the loot box, I wouldn't tell him he can't play it. I would just say, well, all in-app purchases have to go through me anyway, so you don't have to, you're not allowed to do that. I don't let you. Like, I let my son play Overwatch. I just disable the chat, and, if he wants to buy a loot box in Overwatch, I say no, and that's easy. But there's a lot of parents out there that don't understand video games very well, and, because they don't follow this stuff as closely as nerds like me and nerds like you do, they're ignorant to the fact that this game now has gambling in it. And I feel like games with gambling in it should be held back from kids, unless the parents really understand what it is that the kid is playing. And for Nintendo to start out with one monetization model and then change gears and switch to another monetization model, I personally think that is, a little shady to me. I think it's just a little bit shady. So before Nintendo made this change, their monetization model was not as successful as Fire Emblem Warriors, or not Fire Emblem Warriors, Fire Emblem Heroes. Fire Emblem Heroes makes lots and lots of money for Nintendo, but the monetization model that Animal Crossing Pocket Camp used was basically, all right, you want to build this thing in your camp, then it's going to take 3 days, but it could go faster if you pay us 99 cents. And that's fine. That doesn't bother me at all. There are very patient people out there who can unlock everything in the game without spending any money. And guess what? You can probably still unlock everything in the game. Well, maybe not, without spending money in Animal Crossing Pocket Camp. But now, after 6 months, Nintendo has changed it. So now Animal Crossing Pocket Camp has these loot boxes. And let me open up the link here. And if you want to read the article, which I clicked the wrong thing. If you want to read the article from Eurogamer, I suggest that you do if you are interested in this game at all. Basically what they did is the addition is fortune cookies. Now, fortune cookies have been in Animal Crossing, like, I haven't played anything for Animal Crossing before New Leaf, but in New Leaf, you could go in, you could spend some bells on a fortune cookie, and it would have a random item that you may have already had, or maybe you didn't have, and that was fine because it wasn't real-world money, and that doesn't bother me. They brought fortune cookies into this version of Animal Crossing, and the addition of fortune cookies... they have random items from specific, exclusive, and time-limited sets. So that means that there are items that you can only get from fortune cookies, and you can only get them for a short amount of time. Once that window of time is gone, that means that that item is no longer going to be able to be received by a player unless they bring it back in another fortune cookie. Now they have two kinds of fortune cookies. They have premium fortune cookies and non-premium fortune cookies. And the premium fortune cookies, they have, cool new furniture. They'll have clothing. They'll have larger props, which will unlock, special story scenes with you and your animal friends. And, the non-premium fortune cookies will have a separate pool of randomized items. And now you end up buying your fortune cookies for leaf tickets. So you use real money to buy leaf tickets, and then you use the leaf tickets to buy the fortune cookies. And yes, there are ways to earn leaf tickets in-game, but it's pretty tough from what I hear. And each fortune cookie costs 50 leaf tickets. So... there's a new Tom Nook in a Bathtub of Money bundle. This is $40 basically. And that is, oh, no, hold on. Oh, I'm mistaken. So that one's $40. This is a new one. This is $75 for 2,500 leaf tickets, which is 50 fortune cookies. So that means you're spending $75 to pull that slot machine arm 50 times. That is crazy to me. Now, I know why, I understand why Nintendo's doing this. Nintendo released their information about Animal Crossing Pocket Camp versus Super Mario Run versus Fire Emblem Heroes. And of those three, Fire Emblem Heroes made buckets more money. Now, Animal Crossing Pocket Camp was kind of in the middle of the two, and then Super Mario Run made the least amount of money, and that's because they had three different monetization models. The monetization model for Fire Emblem Warriors is just like this. You play a slot machine to get the thing that you want, and the more that you spend, the more likely it is that you're going to get the thing that you want. And Animal Crossing, they had the thing that I already talked about, where it was just to speed up waiting. And then finally, Mario Run, that was you spend $10 and you're done. You never have to spend another dime. You get everything in the game after that. Now, mobile users are their own worst enemy, and they complained a lot about the Super Mario Run monetization model because they didn't want to spend $10 because apparently they would much rather spend $75 to pull a gambling, a slot machine arm in a game. And this is just absolutely asinine to me. Now, Like I said before, I understand why Nintendo did this, but I thought that Nintendo was above this kind of crap. And I feel like it is much worse for them to, like, when Fire Emblem Heroes came out, that was the monetization model, and everybody knew that from the start. But for Nintendo to switch gears like this and introduce this monetization model after the fact, I feel like it is underhanded, shady nonsense, and it really ticks me off. And I don't even really care about this game. I'm not interested in playing this game. But if this is the kind of stuff that we're going to see from Nintendo, I do not want to see, I fear how this is going to leak across into the other stuff that Nintendo does. Now, I'm sure there are some people out there that might say, well, Nintendo didn't really make this game. DNA made this game, and Nintendo's just licensing their characters for it. And while that may be true, I don't think that there's a chance in hell that DNA did this without Nintendo's approval. I'm pretty sure that Nintendo has their fingers in this situation deep, and it really, really bothers me that they're doing this. Now, I'm curious as to how you guys feel about this. For me, it does not affect me, but I still don't like what they're doing. It seems underhanded, greedy, and it just seems beneath Nintendo to me. That being said, I really want to hear what you guys think about this change to Animal Crossing. So let me know, runjumpstomp@gmail.com, or you can tweet at me @runjumpstomp. There we go. Hey, Rezd, what's up, man?